Alright guys, number 2 mod on my top 20 fancy mod list for medieval Total War Kingdoms is none other than Total War The Elder Scrolls, made by Lord Nazgul and Daedra Warrior, and they released this on modibet.com of course. So this is the second best fancy mod in my book for medieval Total War Kingdoms. It's based on the Elder Scrolls. We have two campaigns, we have the Third Era and the Fourth Era. The Fourth Era is the more recent campaign. I like the Third Era more, I believe. I have the Morrowind game, I have the others too. I believe I don't have Skyrim, I have the Oblivion game. I've only played the Morrowind a little bit. But I always liked the Dark Elves the most. So we can see that it has a huge map. Every faction. We have really nice looking interface here, so we can play as the Cyrodiil Empire, Kingdom of Skyrim. We can see that there aren't as many factions as in the submod that I previewed earlier, but we have very polished factions in this mod, and the campaign is very much polished in every area. The only area where it isn't really polished is the area with, I believe, custom cities. There are still vanilla cities in some areas, but that's understandable. Okay, so we have, but we have a lot of custom cities in this mod too. Okay, Cyrodiil Empire, and the Nords of Skyrim, Kingdom of Skyrim actually. We have the Kingdom of Daggerfall. You can see that the Cyrodiil Empire, they consist of Imperials and are led by Emperor Uriel Septim VII. We have the Kingdom of Skyrim, where the inhabitants are Nords. They are led by High King Tyan, the Snowrod. And then we have the Kingdom of Daggerfall, Britons. The people are Britons, and then Britons, and then their king is King Gotred. Okay, we have the Kingdom of Vaerest, they are also Britons, and their king is King Eadvire. Okay, Eadvire, okay. We have Clan of Forebears, and their people are the Red Guards, their king is King Lothen. And we have the Clan of Crowns, also Red Guards, and they have a lord named Amon al-Tanet. So they are like the Middle Eastern factions of the mod, these two. And these are like the Britannic faction, and then the Viking and the Rome. Okay, so we have Romans, we have Vikings, we have Britons, and we have Middle Easterners. And then here we have the Kingdom of Osinium, the Orcs. They own a very small area in the mod. They are infantry based. They're called Orcimers in this world, or Orcs. King Gortvug Grunagorm is their leader. We have the Aldmir Dominion down here. They also have areas in this area, the main world, so to speak. They are Altmers, or High Elves. The leader is Talsar, the Eagle Primarch of the Aldmir Dominion. Primarch of the Aldmir Dominion. We have the Kingdom of Valenwood, the Wood Elves in this area, the Bosmers, the Heart King Camoran, Kaltas is their leader. Then we have the Weird Kayit factions. They are like humanoid tigers or cats. They are like tigers, panthers, etc., but they walk on two legs and such. So the Kingdom of Palatine, they are Kayits, and the leader is Nad Hatta the Main. And then we have another such faction, the Kingdom of Aniquina, led by King Ashad. And then we have the Clans of Black Marsh. Their faction consists of Argonians. Their leader is Chieftain Ansaw, so they are like reptiles on two legs. Then we have the Great House Lalu. We have a bunch of Dark Elven factions now. So the Great House Lalu is one of the Great Houses of the Dark Elves. The Dark Elves in the Elder Scrolls world are named or known as Panmars. So their leader is King Lalu Halset. Then we have the Great House in Doril, and their leader is Lord Vivek. We have the Great House Telvanni. Their leader is the Archmagister Gotren. And we have the Great House Redoran, the Archmaster Bolven Venom as their leader. Then we have the Great House Dress, with leader Master Odron Mariti. And then we have the final faction, Great House Daggett, with the leader Lord Agatur. I believe also that the Undead are a faction in the game, but not playable. They have very few units, and they spawn. And also there are the Oblivion hordes that will spawn through a script too. They are very strong and have a unique roster. They are not playable. And we have the, I believe, Ashlanders, the tribes of Ashlanders, another Dark Elf faction that is more like a nomad Dark Elf faction and not playable. The difference between the Dark Elves is that the Great House Helalu, I believe they can see are cheap troops and good set of archers, weak cavalry, very little infantry. Their best unit is a melee unit. The Great House in Doril, that's the priest faction, has a strong infantry and crossbowmen. So they have good infantry and good crossbowmen. Riders are weak, like all factions of Morrowind. High order narrators are their best units. So they have more elite troops, in my opinion, than the others. Great House Sylvani, they are a mage faction. They have powerful wizards, including battle mages, weak cavalry and infantry. So their infantry is not very good either. Their Telvanni masters are their best unit. So, in other words, we have one Dark Elf faction that is mage based and one that is more elite with a religious order styled ensemble of elite troops. So it's like higher, their troops are better and more elite. We have the Lalud, they are just infantry with weak cavalry. Okay. Then Redoran, I believe, strong and trained infantry, weak cavalry. They are like Lalud, but with some differences. Great House Dress, I believe, is the weakest faction. Numerous and outlandish infantry troops, good archers, very weak cavalry. And they are like Lalu and Redoran, but with weaker troops, and they have fewer areas too. And then Great House Daggett is very different. They have a lot of corrupted Dark Elf units, demonic units and such. Puts on the battlefield terrible creatures that strikes fear in others. Numerous magicians, powerful heavy infantry, lack professional armies. Sanded Sleepers are their best units. So this is like a monster version of the Dark Elves monster faction. Okay, so they have a bunch of factions we can check out. Let's start the game as the Great House Daggett. So this is my first ever top 20 video for mods of Medieval 2. I wanted to do one a long time, but I kind of suck at doing videos like this. I mean, I'm not used at doing them. So but we'll try. I just felt like, you know, giving my opinion on the top 20 mods for Medieval 2 to Lord Kingdoms. And starting with the fantasy mods, of course, and I want to do top 20, not top 10, because others have done top 10. I thought we could do a top 20. But it might not be the best attempt, it's my first. So we got event picks at start, so it shows that it's very detailed. So how's the god starts at Dagodur, this volcano here. The models are totally custom, of course. we'll use the toggle foul sheet to get the, all of the map visible. Unlike the submod, this mod doesn't have nearly as many factions on the map, but it has just as polished a campaign. Campaign is very much polished with a lot of events and scripts and features and gameplay options and such. Custom models, custom settlements in many areas, but not everywhere. There are some areas with vanilla cities still. Custom heroes with custom models, custom music based on the Elder Scrolls franchise. Yeah, it's a really good mod, Medieval Total War Kingdoms, and the second best fantasy mod in my book because it's so polished. The submod I previewed earlier could probably have been higher up on the list, but this one is the original mod and was last updated a few months back, so it's been updated recently. Okay, and this is the latest version, version 2.4 or something, or 2.0, I don't know. I forgot, but anyway, that's a really cool campaign with many factions playable and such, and then we can exit to the main menu again. They also have the 4th era campaign, some different factions available. We can check custom battle, see that they have a bunch of factions here, including the undead and the hordes of oblivion, the tribes of Ashlanders. So they have more factions in custom battle, and those factions will spawn during the campaign, but are not playable. Okay, let's start a quick battle to check some units in battle too. We did check the other ones, we can check this one too. Alright, start deployment. So here we have is Skull Warriors. We are playing as the Great House Lalu, and these units are probably mercenaries. Really cool unit, I haven't seen them before. Might be a new unit of the mod. And we have Lalu Spearmen. Really cool Dark Elf unit. Some Morrowind Spear Militia, they're basic troops. And we have some cavalry. Lalu Cavalry, mounted on these Silt Striders. No, the Silt Striders are the bigger mounts, these are different. I don't remember the name of those mounts. So we have a bunch of different unique models. Okay, let's start the battle, pause the game, check the enemy. The enemy is the Clans of Crowns. Clans of Crowns. So one of the Arab styled factions. We have some cool units here too, including heavy infantry, some African looking units. Yeah, this is Arab inspired. Some of their units are mercenaries, like the ones with the stag horns here. So my vocabulary is not the best sometimes. I'm not a native English speaker, as I said, but yeah, so I can forget words sometimes. Okay, here we have the Hammerfell bodyguard actually. Okay, so we have a bunch of different unique models. And all the factions are unique and custom and all that. And this mod is really polished with everything, so in my opinion it's the second best fantasy mod for Medieval Total War Kingdoms. Alright, and now the final one. And the final mod on my top 20 fantasy mod list for Medieval Total War Kingdoms, ladies and gentlemen, version 4.6, Ariadne Rises of Divide and Conquer is Submod for the Third Age Total War. This is the number one mod. It's always at the top on modderbit.com and in other places. It's without question the most popular mod, and it's the best mod according to many players. We will go immediately to the War of the Ring campaign. So this Submod of Third Age Total War added the maximum number of factions. You can play as the Kingdom of Gondor, led by Stuart Denethor still. You have the Principality of Dol Amroth, a new faction added to this submod, led by Prince Adrahil of Dol Amroth. You have the Northern Dunedain. Leader is Chieftain Aragorn, so he's the Aragorn the Dunedain Ranger here, which is more correct than having him as King of Eriador. Okay, and then we have Adoname. Pretty much the spawning faction, I believe. I think they are the Umber, the Pirates of Umber, I believe. The new name. The leader is Ar-Gimilchad is their leader. Ar-Gimilchad of Adoname. Kingsman. If you see King of Gondor. Gondor, Dalamroth, Northern Dunedain, Kingsman, okay. And then we have the Breeland. So they are, the name is changed from Eriador to the Free Peoples of Eriador in earlier versions of this mod, and then now they have been changed to Breeland. Okay, the leader is Council Master Boleman. Okay. And then we have the Dunlendings, like a Viking Norseman faction. League with Saruman White and the Isengard Orcs. Their leader is Chieftain Yagtak. And their heir is Huntmaster Fred or whatever. Okay. So the Dunlendings. They are a faction in their own right here. In the old Third Age of War, I believe they were. There were some Dunlendings in the armies of Isengard. I believe Isengard still has Dunlendings in their army, but now they have their own faction here. And these areas do not belong to Isengard anymore. We have the clans of Enidveit, another Norseman faction, which is holding areas over here. Really cool faction that I played in the earlier versions of Divide and Conquer, I believe in 2014 and 2013. December 2013 was the year when the first version of Divide and Conquer released. And I played during the spring of 2014. It was before I started to mod the game extensively. So Enidveit is another Norseman faction, and I think they are ranged, while the Dunlendings are more melee. I'd say the Dunlendings are more like the Danes in real history, while the clans of Enidveit, they are more based on their, I believe their strength lies with their archers and such. They have some good infantry too, and I think this faction was more badass looking, at least the older versions of it. I don't know if they have been changed. I think they are the same, but I don't know. I haven't played 4.6. I installed it immediately when they released it, but I haven't played it. Okay, we have the Haradrim tribes. I played older versions, and I've checked this version too, looked at the map and the units and such, but I played only the older versions of this mod. Okay, so Haradrim tribes, the leader is Serpent Lord Kusama. Okay, and the leader of the clans of Enidveit were Moot Lord Trimac. Okay, and the Haradrim tribes start down here, so they only hold one area at the start. Pain. So you need to take a bunch of areas from rebels, probably, meaning the Haradrim are not a very strong faction in the start of the campaign. Then we have the Variags of Khan. They have a bunch of areas from the start. The leader is Khan Arkish. Okay, so the Haradrim might be weaker at the start, but will become stronger. The Variags of Khan, they have infantry and long-ranged infantry, and they have horse cavalry. but the Heradrim, they have the giant Muma kill all offense, so that's why they become strong. They also have Trollmen of Herad, but they start weaker with fewer areas. Then we have Rune, the Easterlings of Rune. Okay, the leader is Lokkan Rukar, and they are really cool units in golden armor and such, golden mail, and they use a lot of phalanxes and such. They are really cool. An old faction. I believe the new ones we have seen here are Dol Amroth, Principality of Dol Amroth, Morten Dunedain, our other name, and Dunlendings, Class of Anidwaite, and Variags of Khand. They are the new ones. And then we have the Dwarves of Khazad-dûm, starting in Moria. Oh no, they start over here, outside of Erebor, and then you need to... I believe this campaign is a bit scripted, so you need to control their leader, High Lord Balin, same Balin from the Hobbit movies, and then you journey to Moria, and your mission is to take back Moria from the goblins. Okay, you have the Dwarves of Erebor. Leader is King Dane II, Ironfoot, the commander of King Thorin's army. I believe Thorin died, so now the leader is King Dane II instead. Okay, then we have the Dwarves of Eredluin. The leader is Clan Lord Gor. They hold this area, so you can say that Erebor and Eredluin have been divided into two factions, and then there is a faction without a settlement that needs to play with a very scripted campaign where you can reconquer Moria. Okay, and in the earlier in Third Age, Total War, these two factions were one faction, and this faction didn't exist. Then we have the Kingdom of Dale, led by King Bane. No, King... Yeah, King Bane. Okay. And we have the Kingdom of Rohan, leader is King Theoden in this mod. Then we have Vale of Dorvinion, leader is Vine Regent Haven. So they're over here. They are very similar to the Dale faction, use different skins, I believe. They also have access to very weird elves if you pick a certain option during gameplay. You have the Anduin Vale, and the leader is Huntmaster Beorn, so you can play as Beorn's faction from the Hobbit movies. He didn't have a faction in the Hobbit movies. I believe his people had been killed by the goblins and orcs. He was the only one left, but in this mod you can place his faction and prevent that from happening. Okay, your enemies will be the orcs of Mr. Mountains and Dol Guldur. Okay, and the orcs of Gundabad over here. Okay, then we have the High Elves. They are once again combined into one faction in earlier versions of this mod, Divide and Conquer. They were two different factions, the Elves of Rivendell and the Elves of Lindon, but now they are combined into one faction, led by Elrond of Rivendell. Okay, then we have Mordor. We have Dol Guldur, and it's become its own faction with a new roster compared to Mordor. Similar orcs, but different. We have the Goblins of Moria. Their new name is Goblins of Moria instead of Orcs of the Misty Mountains. Okay, and they're the enemy that I believe Balin of Khazad-dûm will need to face. Then we have the Remnants of Angmar over here, and the Orcs of Gundabad next to the Remnants of Angmar. They are two different factions. We have the Dominion of Isengard under Saruman. We have the Realm of Lórien. Leader is Lord Celeborn. By the way, I forgot to check the leaders, but Saruman was Isengard's leader. We have King Masog leading the Orcs of Gundabad, and Overlord Agandaur, the leader of the Remnants of Angmar. And we have High Chieftain Uglag leading the Goblins of Moria, and Lord Camel leading Dol Guldur, and Sauron leading Order, of course. Okay, and the elves, they are led by Lord Celeborn, and not Galadriel. I don't even think that Galadriel has her own model here. If I ever am gonna play the Galadriel in this mod, I will probably port her from the other mod, because I like that model. Okay, Woodland Realm. So the Elves of Sylvan. Woodland Realm, they are led by King Tranduil still. Just like in the Hobbit trilogy. Legolas' father. Okay. And we can start the game. It's Isengard. Check this mod too. On the map. Here we have a nice picture of Galadriel. In Dol Guldur, I believe. The loading took a while. Very nice art style here. Kind of look like the actor, but still, it's made by an artist, not the photography of the actor. Okay. So here in the campaign, we have a welcome message, and we have the info of the Dominion of Isengard. We have some options and scripts. You can choose. Automatic information. Okay, let's use toggle FAU. We have a huge map. Probably the same map as in the other mods, but with some differences. I believe they have edited the map in different ways. So, here at this week at start, we have the other factions here. They have the same areas we saw in the faction selection screen. Okay, and the map has 199 regions. Most of Leo Civil UF's and King Kong's custom settlement models are in use, such as Helm's Deep, Edoras, Minas Tirith, and Eastern of Gilead, and we have Minas Morgul. We have the Black Gate, we have Barad-dûr, a bunch of other areas too. This mod is the most popular medieval Total War mod, and it's a fantasy mod, so it's the number one mod of all. I believe even on my list of top 20 mods from medieval 2, this one would win. So this is the top one mod from Medieval 2 Total War Kingdoms. But in my list for historical mods, it won't be a part of it, because it's not a historical mod. Okay, so we will have completely different mods on the list for historical mods. But on my top 20 lists that combines fantasy mods and historical mods, we will have this one at the top, that's for sure. It's not just the most popular mod, but it's also one of the best. It has custom models in battle, it has custom settlements almost everywhere. And it has a lot of events and scripts and features and such. But I believe the Third Age of War 4.0 mod that released an update a week ago might have some models that are more recent that are not in use here. And Reforged also has some models that are not in use by this mod. But this mod is using some of the models that Reforged were first at using. But I believe that this mod has a better campaign than both the other mods. 4.0, a close second when it comes to Third Age mods. The Reforged campaign is really unfinished. So that's why it can't really compete with the other two. But when it came to the unit rosters, it had better rosters for some factions, in my opinion. This mod still has very good rosters and custom music and other stuff, so it's a very good mod. And I even spent 2 months working on a music mod for an earlier version of Divide and Conquer that I released in November 2016. I removed it from modderbay.com a year ago because of copyright. I didn't get a warning or anything, but you know, I didn't want, even though I cut all the songs in half or more, so it was not the full tracks, but still, I believe I only used smaller parts of each song, and specifically used them for certain scenes in the game. For example, if I played as Mordor, I only used the Mordor tracks, and Isengard only used Isengard tracks, etc. So it was faction specific, and I also cut anything else. In the original tracks, I believe that a song could be 10 minutes long, and that song would include songs from many different scenes in the movies, so you could have like Rohan music and Isengard music in the same song. And I cut those songs so that they became faction specific. That music submod still works in version 1.1 of Divide and Conquer that I still have on my computer, but and on version 1.2. But it doesn't work on this version because it's not been adjusted to the new map changes. It's the same map, I believe, but they moved around some areas. I believe they moved some regions. Maybe removed a region and added another one and such. And that means that the songs will work in most areas, but in the new areas that have been changed or added, they will it will not have any songs playing. I remember using a trainer back in 2016 and checking every single area on the map, which took an entire night to make sure that every area played a song, because it's easy to miss out on one area or so. And when you play the game as one faction, the chances are that you won't play in every single area. It's 199 areas after all. But I did use a cheat, so I could just move to every single area very fast. I had unlimited movement points. Okay, but this mod has a really well made campaign, and it's the best third age campaign in today. It's the best third age campaign available today, and it's the most popular medieval total war mod, and it's number one on my list. If we check custom battle, see that it has a bunch of factions here, even though they don't have to use the maximum number of 31 factions, but still a big number. So we have at least 16 factions playable. If we look at the Isengard faction, you can see that they have some new models compared to the old version, but also that the models are not as updated as in Reforged. We can check Rohan, for example. See that they have a huge roster, but that most of the rosters look similar to the ones in 4.0. There may be some new units here too, but the roster is not as impressive as the one in Reforged. Okay. Isengard, by the way, has the old siege engines, not the new one. So, this mod is number one on my top 20 list. Thank you for watching, and yeah, this is it. Bye.